Oh, God. Hello and welcome to Taskmaster Minnesota, episode 7, new location.
Oh.
And you know what? Brand new game. We're wiping the scores. All the points go to the baby.
Oh.
My bet in episode 1's paying off.
Yeah.
All right. I haven't done this yet. I don't know why. My name's Carter, in case you weren't paying enough attention. I'm Carter. And here are the contestants. We have Brie. Not Cole. Eric. Ian. Jackson. And Parker. And sitting beside me is my very normal assistant, David Hawk.
Thank you. I should say before we get started, Cole is not with us today because he, I believe, staged a violent military coup and has taken control of the Canadian government. So in his place today, we have Owen from Taskmaster Minnesota Season 1. Owen, are you excited to be back on Taskmaster representing Cole? All right, enough said. Thank you. I think that speaks for itself. Okay. Okay, now this is very exciting. For today's banter section, I have a very special message from Dejan, the Taskmaster and creator of Sfidamastro, the Italian version of Taskmaster. So let's take a look at that.
Okay. Buongiorno, nice to meet you all. I'm Dejan, and I'm behind the Italian fan-made version of Taskmaster called Sfidamastro. I love Taskmaster Minnesota. I hope you're having so much fun doing it. You included, Owen.
Pensavo non ci fossimo accorti del tuo gioco diplomatico. You idiot! Cinque foto di te che ti diverti da morire mangiando in un ristorante italiano o sarai per sempre bandito dall'Italia!
Having said this, I wish you a great episode and also say in Italy che vinca il migliore. Ciao!
It hasn't been 5 minutes and we're starting with death threats. New record for sure.
I saw the same, you know, flag of Italy that I made during that episode, and I was like, oh, I wonder if he's gonna bring that up. And he did.
So if by the time this episode airs on YouTube, Owen has completed the task assigned to him of eating in 5 Italian restaurants, I will put the pictures on the screen now. If he has not done it, I will put a big ban from Italy stamp over his face now.
Does Olive Garden count?
I think you actually get points taken away. Yeah.
Every Olive Garden breadstick is one more Italian restaurant.
Can I invite you on a date? I've got a fancy Italian restaurant I've been thinking of visiting.
Okay. I'll love free food.
Well, before we flirt anymore, can we get a series scoreboard up there?
Yes, let's take a look at the series scoreboard. This is so exciting. It's the closest, it might be the closest any series has ever been. We have 4 people, all within 3 points of the lead. Eric with 86, Parker 87, Brie 88, Jackson currently in the lead by 1 point with 89 points. everything's still left to play for today.
Are we starting with the prize task today?
Yes, we finally are starting with the prize task today. For this season, the prize task was to bring in the most Minnesotan thing. Whoever brings in the most Minnesotan thing will earn 6 points, and whoever wins the entire show at the end of episode 8 will take home all 6 Minnesotan things. Oof-da!
We'll start in the order you gave me. Parker, what did you bring?
Okay, so Minnesota, very cold, snow, ice, that's kind of like our MO. So I brought, can I bring it up here?
Yeah, you can grab it.
Do you need a hand?
You know what, I think I can manage this. Okay. In honor of that sort of cold, icy veneer, I brought today 60 pounds of ice.
Very nice.
Yeah, get bring it up here.
Pass it around. Come on, don't be shy.
Take some handfuls
important
of ice.
Important side note, though.
Can I eat this?
You guys haven't won it yet.
Oh, okay. Once you win it, you can eat all 60 pounds.
Okay, I will.
The bucket is not part of the prize, so you do need to transport the ice yourself if you win.
Okay.
Great. All right. Who's Jossie next?
Jackson.
All righty. Let me grab it here. So, there are a few things more Minnesotan than alcoholism. And also, the other, the kind of the duality of Minnesotans is also kind of needless politeness and passive aggression. So I have a case of Hams, you know, iconic beer for drinking copious amounts of, but with only the one can left that everyone was far too polite to take. So whoever wins today will get this lovely can of Hams.
And are never allowed to drink it.
Yes.
A nearly empty case. Yes. Okay.
Yep.
All right.
I think we're going to learn a lot from me today. I brought a 536-page pseudoscientific book proving that the Kensington runestone was actually real. It's a history book, but it's written, as you see in the foreword, that it was written by an engineer. And it basically spends the first, 10 pages saying that everybody else who has ever written on the subject was wrong, actually. and so it's very Minnesotan because it's just, you know, it's all about Kensington, way up north.
How many pages is it?
536. Okay. Plus index and acknowledgments. And they are full pages, you can see.
Looks, yeah.
It's good to know that they're actually not skimping out on the half
pages.
My
goodness. Are not colored.
I am sorry. But do note that we have both Impact and Papyrus font on the cover.
Oh, that's a good sign. That's a good sign.
That's a good
sign. All right. Eric, what did you bring?
All right, so I'm going to have to bring it up just like Parker, but I thought kind of Minnesota is known for two very different things. One, our passive aggressivism, kind of like Jackson said. But secondly, our sports teams are kind of awful at winning finals. For baseball, the Twins, last time we won the MLB championship was 1991. That's 32 years ago. For Minnesota United, for soccer, we won in 2011, but that was the inaugural season. So we still suck. For football, for basketball, and for hockey, we've actually never won the championship, respectively.
Right.
So, and I kind of dubbed this the consolation prize, because there's honestly nothing more passive aggressive than winning a consolation prize, which just tells you, you know, you tried, but you still suck.
Okay. Nice. Okay. If you hold it up there. Owen, what did Cole bring in?
Oh no.
Cole brought in some amazing maple syrup.
Mm.
And everyone knows.
And where is it from, Owen?
Wesley, Ontario. But we all know Minnesota or Canada is just Greater Minnesota, so you know. And
why
there's all
are you
that.
Trying to get one. In trouble what? With as many foreign nations? All right, Brie, what did you bring in?
So I come from a very Minnesotan family, and
something we do every single time we see each other because we don't know how to talk is we play a game of cribbage or 10. I brought in a Minnesota engraved cribbage board as well as Minnesota cards with photos of Minnesota locations as well.
Wow. Hold on, it's not just Minnesota engraved. It is Taskmaster Minnesota engraved. Whoa. Whoa.
I'm noticing there's something on the pins too. What's on the tips of the pins?
So there's Minnesota and the loons, which is our state bird. And then bass, which is a pretty common fish.
Oh my gosh. Wait, I didn't even know about the pins. That's great.
Wow. Yeah.
Okay.
I can't even think of anything silly and disparaging to say. This is just really,
this is really cool.
We have
ice, an almost empty can of beer, a book that is a historically inaccurate book, a shrine to sports failures, an imported bottle of syrup, and a genuinely thoughtful and cool book.
Strong line.
Yeah, I can't decide who's gonna win.
Quick question, would you be comfortable with awarding points based on the weight of the
I would second that one.
I would be comfortable, but I'm not gonna do it. Okay.
That's fair.
First off, in last place with 1 point, Ian's book of not true. I mean, yeah, Minnesota is ranked better than average in education, so I would hopefully believe the average Minnesotan wouldn't believe something like that. Fingers crossed. So that's last. Second to last place is the imported maple syrup.
Hey, you... Dude, you got 2 points at least for that.
Yeah, so third. Sorry, tied for third place. I could not decide between the case, the almost empty case of hams, and the bucket of ice. So Parker and Jackson tied for third place with 4 points each. In second place, which one did I put in second place? Second place, we have the consolation trophy.
Very fitting.
Very fitting. So, yeah. Hopefully this ages poorly, but it probably won't. And in first place, the obvious choice. Please, cribbage board. Amazing. Give it up for Brie.
I'm really hoping I win the season.
Can we please see the first recorded task of the day?
Yes, our first task today comes to us from Taskmaster New Zealand, where it originally started off as a tiebreaker task, but then was upgraded into a full-fledged task. Similarly, I gave this task to our contestants as an intended tiebreaker, but here we are. It is now a full-fledged task. Let's take a look.
Taskmaster.
I'm here for it.
Hi, David.
I feel like I've already fucked something up. We'll start there.
How are you guys?
I'm good.
Good.
Squirt the soap the furthest. You have one attempt. Any soap that hits the tarp will be counted as your attempt.
Furthest distance wins. That's it. There's no time.
I didn't think it would take a lot of time. So.
I see. Yeah.
So long as it doesn't hit the tarp, I'm allowed to like just squirt the soap, right?
Yeah, it won't count as your attempt.
It won't count as my attempt until it hits the tarp.
But what defines a squirt?
Well, that's sort of up to you. That's between you and the Taskmaster.
Okay.
Pretty simple. I thought this was going to be a 2 second, task, everybody just in and out, but here it is. Okay. First up to the squirting line, it's Eric, Brie, and Ian.
Squirting line, don't say that.
Let's start out with a neutral. So that's
That's pretty good.
That's pretty close.
That's pretty close.
That's not too bad.
I wonder if I'm squeezing this. No, it does. It goes way less far. Maybe upside down. What does that do? Okay, I guess you gotta. You don't want to do it too quickly, right? Yeah.
Okay. Okay, great. All right, so stay there.
Yep.
I think it actually went past the tarp.
It did. Okay. It did.
I don't think so. I think you had a dry squirt there. Oh.
Oh, that's not as far as I was hoping.
The wind is coming in. Probably, you know, most advantageous for me to stand right here. Probably higher up is better. Just wait for the wind to come back. Get maximum, you know. Okay, 3, 2, 1. I'm not certain I could have done much better, but I don't. I think it's possible. Bye.
That tailwind really helped.
Yeah, it did. Yeah. Oh my god, I think it would have gotten even less.
Fun. Yeah, yeah.
I saw it get picked up by the wind and carried that extra centimeter.
It was rather elegant.
Yeah. I love Ian just being like, maybe I could have done better, but I don't know. That seemed pretty good. And it's so funny because Ian was the first person to film, so I was like, yeah, that was pretty good. I have the distances here. After the initial dry squirt, Brie squirted the soap the length of 4.7 baseball bats, which is about 4.7 meters. So Eric squirted the soap pretty far, but a lot of it went past the tarp. So he squirted 5.12 meters, but he was standing right at the edge of the tarp, and the tarp was only 3.7 meters long, so he couldn't have gotten a score higher than that, unfortunately.
Mm. I got some soap on the tarp,
yes,
though.
Definitely not disqualified yet. There was soap at the end of the tarp, so 3.7 meters is the measurement I have written down. Ian squirted soap the length of a guitar if you cut off the top of it, making it completely useless. 86 centimeters.
That's right. 85 more centimeters than I thought I got.
Well, because we measured vertical distance, too. Yeah. Well, next up, squirting all by himself, it's Jackson.
Are there any rules on what the soap can do after it's squirted before it hits the tarp? All right, I think my strat is gonna be, I don't know, fuck off really far that way, squirt it into my hand and then place it onto the tarp, because that is one squirt of soap.
Okay.
I think that'll count. Yeah, all right, I'll be back.
Okay.
All right, I'm gonna squirt now. Okay, there's my squirt of soap.
Okay, great work, Jackson.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, thanks, David.
Bye-bye.
Okay.
Jackson.
Yes.
What do you think about that?
Well, upon examining the phrasing of the task, it just said, "What? Do we have the exact wording available?"
Yeah, let me pull it up.
Because it did just say you just have to squirt soap the farthest.
Mm-hmm. Squirt the soap the furthest. You have one attempt. Any soap that hits the tarp will be counted as your attempt.
Oh. Okay.
So. It seems like that means it would be allowed, because it squirted very far away, and then it hit the tarp.
Yeah.
But did he squirt it onto the tarp?
It didn't say you had to do that.
I mean, the soap did land on the tarp, so I think he did.
It didn't even, he put it on the tarp.
Okay, that's up to you, yeah.
I will mull it over, depending on how bad the other two attempts are.
Regardless of
regardless of validity, points awarded for gusto. That was impressive.
Yeah. Yes. He didn't need to do the jump, but that was great.
My entire thing was just the way it was phrased was pretty ambiguous. That's the only reason I attempted
that. Like he was a squirt the whole
time. I was the squirt, yeah.
It was incredible.
I embodied the essence of a squirt.
Was there one or more pumps in there, though? I felt like I saw you do more than one pump.
I love talking about squirting soap, but we're going to stop doing that and see more times now.
Okay. Our last two squirt athletes are Parker and Cole.
Squathletes.
Squathletes.
Oh. He's leaving.
All right, well, I guess we're climbing a tree. Okay. This should be enough to beat everybody who doesn't have the same idea.
Ha ha. Okay, okay. I know that this comes undone. I've done this in the past.
Five points if you die, though. Oh, stop. I hit it.
Okay, good.
Okay.
Let's go. All right, now all I have to do is get down without dying, and I won't be eliminated from Taskmaster.
Okay.
Okay. Did I soap get on the tarp?
Yeah.
Yay! Okay, that's it. I did it.
Thanks, Parker.
No, thank you, David.
We all speculated that Parker was going to break a lot of things at the cabin. This was the first task that he filmed, and he did break the soap dispenser. Okay, well, I've measured theirs in terms of me. Parker's squirt was about 3.5 Davids, 6.6 meters, and Cole's was just over 4 Davids, 8 meters. So, okay. That's our scores. So I guess the question is, are you allowing both of those?
They're fine.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Are you allowing Jackson's squirt?
No.
No.
I'll give you a pity point.
Okay.
Pity point.
Okay.
One pity point.
Okay. Okay. I thought you were going to allow it, so I need to change the scores. Okay, well, with that in mind then, the scores for that task is 1 point to Jackson, 2 points to Ian, 3 points to Eric, 4 points to Brie, 5 points to Parker, and the winner of that task is Cole.
How we feeling, Owen?
My wit and guile surprise even myself.
All right. How has that affected the score?
Well, so far it's a rough episode for Ian, as per usual. currently in the lead with 10 points is Brie.
All right, David, what's next?
The time has finally come for our obligatory musical task.
There we go.
Hi, Cole.
Hello. It's an instrument. I hate these.
I'm not a band person, man. Oh, I was a choir kid.
Okay. Music, though.
I don't see a an envelope. Oh. Trick of the light. Mm.
Invent and demonstrate a brand new musical instrument. Most inspiring demonstration of the best new musical instrument wins. You have 30 minutes.
You have 30 minutes? Your time starts now.
Wow.
I could put some stuff inside of other stuff. That's usually a good building plan. Take some objects, and I'll put it inside of another object.
Just a good roadmap for life.
Yeah, right? What? Okay. Let's see. Oh, God, I don't know.
You really got a lot of action out of those boots.
They have
That's true.
Made a lot. Should we give a point to the boots?
Well, the boots that Parker threw over the tree, that was a different set of boots. Just boots in general, just a recurring theme of boots, yeah.
Yeah, shout out to the concept of boots.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
First up, it's J. Cole, which is short for just Cole on his own.
Look, there's a lot of, if I just close this up real quick, you know, and then I just shake it around, you know, that's pretty good, right?
Okay.
That's pretty good. All right, that's the basis for my idea.
There's a lot of glass in there, so.
Oh, erasers, this thing, okay, this is pretty good too. This could be part of the instrument. I mean, here's my master plan. I'm gonna have a box with some items inside, and also within that will be another box, which also has items inside. And it's gonna be like a metaphor for life. You know? Put some rice in there. Could Bach do this? I don't think so. But nothing really fit in the outer layer. It's too.
Maybe a piece of paper.
David. You fool. You think you could. How surprising would it be to find a paper in a box that's made out of paper?
Sorry, I guess I forgot what the task was. That's my bad.
Let's add one more. I feel like most great instruments have a secondary kind of
box.
A secondary box.
Yeah.
Okay, ready? All right. Okay, that's a performance. Yes. Let's go. All right, nailed that one.
I have to say that just looked like a madman and his unwilling accomplice.
Yeah.
It was the ultimate music device box. I mean, come on.
An oversized unfinished maraca. Yeah.
Did he send you any notes on this, on what to say for this one, or
he didn't have to.
Oh, okay.
So he said, could Bach do this? I think the better question is, should Bach do this?
Cole had a very, very odd plan for this task. He wanted it to be, his original vision was that there would be a series of boxes, but it would be an infinite loop where the smallest box would contain the larger box inside of it. So he asked me to go to the store and buy a box that's bigger on the inside. I told him I would if he could tell me which store they sold them at. Another quote from him during that task is he said, infinity is pretty big, but 3 is bigger than 2, so I'll add one more and see if we get there.
Seems like he didn't really invent a musical instrument as much as a philosophical concept.
Okay. All right, we're going to take a look at some more. Next up, it's Link Ian Parker, like Lincoln Park, but Ian and Parker. I thought that's pretty good. Okay, here we go.
Ooh, okay.
I've invented a drum. Invented is a strong word, but.
Tip to tip.
Just as God intended. Innovation. Okay. Some real shit that you would not understand.
I don't understand.
Oh, it's like a musical instrument.
That was cool.
It's,
yeah.
It's like it's got the horses going.
To do is win this episode, and Parker's instrument, the vomophone, is yours.
You need to play us a tune, Parker.
Please, just one more time.
All right.
Now, I'm a little bit rusty. But that's, you know, that's kind of general. Just
fantastic work. Oh, really good stuff. Good stuff.
Would you say that's more like a very janky didgeridoo?
No, because the didgeridoo is to create a new sound outside of the human voice. This exists to amplify and accentuate the human
like
voice.
Like a microphone.
No,
like something else.
Like a vomophone.
Yeah.
Next up, they've been paired together a lot this season, but let's do it again, because why not? It's Eric and Brie. I should mention before we see this that Eric is lactose intolerant, which really shouldn't be relevant to this task, but somehow it is.
Wait, what did I say? What did I do or say?
You know, I always try and think of a way to cheese your tasks.
Right.
Because, you know, it's kind of the whole point, but.
Because right. You can't eat cheese, but this is like the closest you can get.
I can use cheese.
You can't eat it though.
I don't need to.
Okay.
My other thought would be just like having a soundboard.
Why, that makes no sound at all.
That's not what I was expecting.
You're not making any noise.
Like, this is not how I thought this was gonna go.
Uh-oh. It's a good grape. What is happening?
If this doesn't make a noise, I'm actually just gonna throw like a hissy fit, you know?
Okay.
What noise are you expecting these things to make?
I don't know.
This is either going to be incredible or one of the worst things anyone has ever heard in their lives.
Okay.
I feel like anything that I have would ruin a song like this. So I need...
Are you giving me an anime wallpaper?
No, I'm not doing an anime.
Okay. Here's the performance.
We could do it like a song that absolutely everyone loves, mm-hmm.
and everyone is just ecstatic to hear whenever it comes on the radio. Made by a really...
Why are we clapping?
We're clapping for Brie.
So you had a revelation. You can use cheese as an instrument and then just bought a bunch of groceries and threw them on the table.
So I originally took inspiration actually from, you know, mayonnaise as an instrument from SpongeBob. Okay. And then I kind of, I blacked out. Things just kind of happened, yeah,
you were taken over by a spirit, not a creative spirit.
I'd say that's pretty creative. Maybe not.
Good.
No, you know what? That's. Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. Yeah, I think Eric definitely lost sight of what the task was like halfway through. He at one point asked, "Do I have to use only cheese, or am I allowed to use all the foods?"
No, I don't remember any of this. Like, I forgot about this entirely.
You kind of just had David make an instrument.
Well, yeah, and it was hard because he did 20 things and only two of them made any noise.
I would like to point out that Brie has invented the next step up from vaporwave, microwave.
Cooler in my head.
Yeah, I feel like, I mean, I love to do this, but I can't give points out for fantasies.
Thank God you weren't locked into using only cheese.
No more. Yeah. All right, who's next?
Okay. Well, finally, we've saved him for the very last for a good reason. Here's Jackson with his attempt to invent the best instrument of all time.
I like this one.
Like this one?
Yeah.
You a musical guy?
Yes, but I like the idea of getting to do unspeakable things to a beautiful French horn. Oh, yeah. This is good. I don't know if that's gonna... No, I want that crinkly sound, you know? Why would the French do this?
I believe the French horn was invented by the Germans.
Why would the Germans do this? I didn't know that. Why do they call it the French horn then? Whose idea was that?
Probably the French, if I had to guess.
That's awful. This is why I don't respect Europe at all. Absolutely. I call this the Horne de Sade. The namesake being the Marquis de Sade, keeping in the French motif of the French horn. You know, you need a human to be part of the instrument, and the goal is to, modulate and amplify, screams of pain. So, David, if you'll just, yeah, all right, let me see if we can play a scale here. Okay, very nice. How much time do I have left?
10 minutes.
Oh my God. This is a piece that I have devised for my new instrument. It's called Adagio in C. That's pretty warm. One of these. Yeah, okay. Thank you very much.
Okay, thanks, Jackson.
Thanks, David.
Bro, you hit me so hard on the head. I really hurt.
This is not an instrument, it's just a torture device. Yeah,
I really thought Eric's was going to be the most shocking.
That was villainous.
David has his eyes filled with terror.
I regret that pity point I gave you.
The pity point should go to David for having to go through that.
Yeah. Oh, man. He pickled my ass purple. Everyone else's demonstrations were between 10 and 30 seconds long. Jackson's was 2.5 minutes. That was really a tiny snippet of how long he was hitting me with the paddle. He also, okay, this is maybe a more minor thing, but he also pulled out all the tuning slides for no reason, just to annoy me. Just had to retune the horn later.
I do like the mental image of you having to go through and like editing the like best groans of pain that you made.
All right, well, it's time to score them.
So can I have the specific wording of the task again?
Most inspiring demonstration of the best new musical instrument wins. That's actually a good question. There's two criteria.
Gotcha.
The best instrument and the most inspiring demonstration.
Yeah. I've come to a decision. In last place.
Yeah.
Sixth place. Okay, we'll skip that. Let's not dwell on it any longer. In fifth place is Brie for the soundboard, which does exist already. I will admit that.
How is the soundboard losing to just straight up David's painful groan?
I invented a creative new instrument.
Very inspired.
I was inspired as well. Yeah.
Watch out, David.
In fourth place. My inspiration is a force to be reckoned with. In fourth place, we have Cole for his maracas, we'll just call them that. The ultimate musical device, maracas. Maracas. So for maracas 2.0, we have Ian in third place. Second place, we have the vomophone.
I can't. It's a microphone.
And for, in first place, the horn disaid. Yeah,
I agree. That's the best one.
I'm glad you can appreciate my creative vision on that one, Carter. I really do appreciate it.
Yeah, I don't appreciate your creative vision. I recognize it. I don't appreciate it. All right. I don't want to talk about this anymore. Can we please have a new task?
Yes. This next task was suggested by lots of people online, tons of people online. It was actually odd because this one just kept getting said to me over and over again by people who didn't even know about Taskmaster. But people just kept telling me to do it, so I did it. So here's Touch Grass, the task.
Hello, David.
Hello, Eric.
Got an interesting box this time around. Oh, it's got a lock on it.
Well, I don't seem to be able to open this box, so hopefully that has nothing to do with the task.
Touch grass.
Touch grass. You may not leave the room or open any doors or windows until you say the magic word.
The fastest wins, your time starts now.
Let's see if I can use a paper clip or something as a rudimentary lockpick.
I hope not. All right, so we decided to bring back the escape room task. This season, the escape room was significantly harder to sort of reflect the difficulty of touching grass, right? So yeah, makes sense. Well, it might be more appropriate to introduce our first three grass touchers by their online handles. So here is X-Remy, Nago Konami, and Catboy Enthusiast.
Fastest wins, your time starts now. Okay. Tarot, Page of Wands, 29.
Tarot card, Page of Wands, 29. This looks like a set of tarot cards.
Tarot, Page of Wands, 29. Oh, there's another lock here.
All of these years where I've been like, huh, I should learn what tarot means, now it's kicking me in the ass.
I mean, there is a tarot book, if you want to look up what it means.
Is this tarot book?
Yeah. Yeah, okay, sweet.
I hate riddles. I can't stand riddles.
I'm sorry.
Tricks. Deceptions. Oh! 29th word. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 28, 29. Dark, maybe? How do I open the lock?
Just open it.
What do you mean just... Oh.
Words.
Is that the passcode word?
That's not the magic word. I'm sorry.
Okay.
What is
this thing? Seychelles.
Oh, what you got there? Seychelles.
Yeah.
Flag? You're doing good so far, though.
Words. Buy a hint. 5-minute penalty. No way. I'm not doing that shit.
Oh. Found something.
This looks like something. Okay. The string must touch all of the green pins. Okay.
Oh, look at this.
Oh.
Oh, Joy, I love this. I can't stand these puzzles. My brain doesn't work for them. Antigua and Barbuda.
Ooh, what the fuck is that?
It doesn't look like much.
No, it really doesn't. balls.net/archive/images/453.
Yeah, Parker wrote that on the whiteboard about a year ago, and it won't rub off. So you can check it out later if you want.
Well, I probably will. I would like to know what kind of images are hosted on balls.net. Italy! Here's some more colors. Seychelles.
The flag of limited hardware warranty. Not long enough to make words.
Is it not?
W-O-R-D-S. There we go. Okay. Five. Okay. Oh, five?
Very nice.
Five.
I mean, that's precisely the right length, and it's a... the five.
So theoretically, A to Z, Tigua Barbuda, Italy, Seychelles, and South Africa. Oh wait, oh god, that's what it means. Red, black, blue, yellow, white, blue. So it goes five.
Seven?
Oh. Yeah. How'd you get seven?
Italy colors.
Very good.
Blue, yellow, red, white, green. So that's three. Black, yellow, green, white, blue. And red. Nine. 5739, which is then, therefore, probably the code to that.
You see any locks?
Nine. Seven.
Locks? Here we go.
Wow.
I get to see what's in here. That was a pretty cool puzzle. Big fan. Hello, just wanted to check in as you approach the end of this task. Don't give up and don't get discouraged. So once you've got it, quickly open the box. I can rearrange letters in this to say balls and ass.
That's the magic. I am not up yet.
That'll be crazy.
I guess five words into it. So
it's the magic word check.
No, that's a good start.
Check the don't. Get got boss. I forgot. Don't get got is a fucking game. All right.
Don't get got. Oh. Duh. There it is. A key.
Ha ha. Uh oh. Where'd that go?
Oh no.
Where did it? What do you mean? I literally just dropped it.
Oh no.
Where did the key go? The magic word is Worcestershire.
Congratulations, Jackson. You've said the magic word.
Time to go touch grass. Normally, I couldn't be coerced into doing this, but I will for today.
Worcestershire. Let's go.
Right, oh, right there.
I can't help any further. The task is now, yeah, find the key.
Oh my god. Wait.
Incredible.
Oh, here it is.
Oh, oh man.
After all that, pronouncing Worcestershire was nothing to a guy like me.
Thanks, Parker.
Thank you, David.
balls.net/archive/images/453 I hope that's not a virus.
All of our viewers at home should visit that right now.
Upload your own.
It's a great community over there. It's just all around good people.
I'll give the results here. So Jackson completed the task in 35 minutes and 39 seconds. He had the slowest start out of anybody. He took about 20 minutes before he solved the first puzzle, but then everything just fell into place for him right after that. Jackson had one hint penalty for a final time of 40 minutes, 39. Ian touched grass in 34 minutes and 44 seconds and took two hint penalties for a final time of 44 minutes and 44 seconds. Ian also was able to bypass a puzzle because he just guessed the word dark in the first lock because it's his favorite TV show, so he just thought he'd try it. I would say Parker seriously learned from his mistakes last season. He escaped the room in just 30 minutes, 28 seconds, and took no hints. So,
and how much time did he spend looking for the key?
Yeah, that was a significant portion of it. He did great on the puzzles. Yeah. He really did. Okay, that's the sands as they are so far. Let's now see how the other three took my advice to go touch grass. Here's Cole, Eric, and Brie.
Okay, question one. What is the magic word?
Maybe it's please?
Can I please open a door?
No, sorry, that's not the magic word. I took a guess, but it was wrong. Shoot.
Okay.
Fool. The fool, which is what I am right now. And also, the devil.
Mm. That's what I am right now.
Yeah!
Is dark the password?
It is not, but it's but I like that word. Do you like escape rooms, Brie?
I do. I didn't realize this was an escape room.
Oh, okay.
I didn't realize that's what was going on. Oh. This place is such a mess, I didn't realize.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Really hope I'm not missing something blatantly obvious. This is all a bunch of mystical mumbo jumbo to me.
Oh, what'd you get there?
I'm not gonna say what flag I think it is because I'm gonna be wrong and I don't want to be embarrassed.
Okay. Is there anything that would indicate what country
it
is?
Oh, Italy. Okay. That didn't cool. help me at all. Okay.
Was that the country you thought it was?
Yes.
Oh, great.
Okay, and what about this? Seychelles? I wish I were better at finding stuff. Okay, so there was one here, one there, and one there. So if I think about that in, like, escape room terms, it has to be, like, aha! Escape room magic.
Yeah. Okay. Well done. That was your experience coming into play right there.
And there is a flag back here.
Not that one.
Okay. I hope I didn't just touch like somebody's, you know, soldier.
You did, but it's fine.
Oh.
I'm sorry. Oh no.
I feel like this is gonna be one of those things where we're gonna be doing the studio session, mm-hmm. and you're gonna like show it's
right there, right in front of me, and I'm gonna feel so astronomically stupid.
Okay, I don't think there's anything here. What is there?
Second to last combination that I tried.
Wow. Incredible.
Okay.
You took one away from the maximum number of tries possible.
Yes. Just wanted to check in as you approach the end of this task. Don't give up and don't get discouraged. So once you've got it, quickly open the box.
A little encouragement for you.
This is not helpful.
Are you kidding me? Have I been doing this for no reason?
Is that all a red herring thing?
I think this is probably the time to ask for a hint. I'm not.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna ask for a hint.
Cool. Have you looked over here?
Oh no. It's every five words of this message, isn't it? Check the don't get got box.
We're just like,
yes. Yes, that's close enough to the magic word.
Orchestrier.
Close enough. You've said the magic word, sort of, Cole. I mean, I'll just trust that you've touched grass if you just go outside and touch the ground. Okay.
Thank you for the escape room. That was very hard to find everything.
Yeah, it was a hard one. Well, I hope you enjoyed it. Okay, bye.
Embarrassed, shameful
salute.
Dad, I'm so sorry.
That was the most shameful salute of all time.
You didn't even, you turned away from the flag.
All right, I'm going to share the scores here. Eric finished within 20 seconds of Ian's time. Very close between those two. If you recall, Ian finished in 34 minutes and 44 seconds with two hints. Eric also took two hints and took 34 minutes and 25 seconds.
Ooh,
just wow. Beating Eric, Ian. Cole took the longest to touch grass pre-hints at 36 minutes 42, but he also used the most hints with three, finishing with a final time of 51 minutes 42. And Brie, the experienced escape room veteran, finished the room in 27 minutes 23 with no hints.
You made that edit of Eric look a lot worse than I thought. I thought he was going to have like an hour.
Okay. Yeah, it's because he said really funny things.
I don't think people realize like how much stuff there is in that cabin, and so like how hard it is to just find
Brie
something out of place.
Brie complained every day about how messy the cabin was, but especially during this task. Okay, so altogether, the scores for that task are, it's 1 point to Cole, 2 points to Ian, 3 points to Eric, 4 points to Jackson, 5 points to Parker, and the winner of that task is Brie.
All right, can we check the scoreboard?
Actually, before we move on, there's one other thing that I wanted to show everybody about that task. Let's direct our attention to the monitor, please.
Didn't shake it out before putting it on his head.
I was shocked that nobody found it because everybody checked the bag pretty thoroughly, but yeah, nobody saw it. Jackson even had me shine a flashlight into the bag and he still didn't see it.
Yeah.
Well, too bad.
You guys ready for a score check?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Okay, you have to close your eyes.
Okay, Jackson is currently in third place with 15, but it's close at the top with Brie in second place with 18, and Parker in the lead by 1 point with 19 points.
All right. All right. Do we have one more task for today?
We do have one final task. Our final task today allowed our contestants to make a new friend, and then it allowed me to ruthlessly murder them in cold blood.
Taskmaster! Hello.
Hi, Parker.
Hello.
Hi, Eric.
Hello. So do I get to...
We've got a special guest to read this task out for you.
Okay.
Hello there, John Kearns here, recording from London, on his iPad, balanced on a bin, on a chair. I have a task. Protect this balloon. In 10 minutes, David will try to pop the balloon by any means necessary. The balloon may not leave the cabin, and you may not attack or touch David. The balloon that remains inflated for the longest time wins. Your time starts when David blows his whistle, and you may draw a face on your balloon. You may give your balloon a name before the whistle is blown, but of course, you don't have to. Good luck.
John Kearns.
Very cool.
Season 14.
There's the face.
Does your balloon have a name?
No.
Okay.
It remains nameless.
Herbert. Okay. Well, I can't wait to assassinate Herbert.
You won't.
Does your balloon have a name?
His name's Keenan.
Keenan. Okay. Well, I can't wait to kill Keenan. are you going to draw a face on Paul?
Nope. It's just Paul.
Just name. Okay. Well, I can't wait to kill Paul.
That's a very small face. That's what we're working with.
Does the balloon have a name?
We'll go with Martin for now.
Martin. Okay.
I'm feeling Martin.
There's no way you're killing this guy.
Okay. Well, he looks kind of evil, actually.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. His victory is inevitable.
Oh. So... When most people were drawing their faces on the balloons, it was an attempt to garner sympathy from me. You've tried to intimidate me with the face on the balloon.
If you come out with anything you do this balloon, it will return 10 times worse.
Does the balloon have a name?
This balloon will be known as Thanos.
Okay, well, I can't wait to kill Thanos. It's an exciting task. This is definitely, I think, a favorite among pretty much everyone who did this one. Okay, we want my favorites as well. Okay, well, let's just get into it. They had to protect the balloon from me as long as possible. They could not attack or touch me, but other than that, and the balloon couldn't leave the cabin. But other than that, everything was fair game. Our first two valiant defenders of the balloon are Sir Ian and Sir Jackson.
Okay.
But now I'm gonna make it look like I put it other places.
Can I make wacky Home Alone style traps that would harm David? Super visible back there. I feel like the oven is obvious enough. He'll probably check it eventually. Oh yeah.
Here I come.
But,
hello, Ian.
Hello?
Where's your balloon?
Why would I tell you? What are you gonna do to it?
Nothing. Where's your balloon?
I don't know.
Okay.
I didn't have a balloon.
Where is this?
Dude, I never had a... Are you okay? I never had a balloon, dude. Okay.
This seems suspicious.
Does it?
Ha ha! Oh, no. Oh, God. Is it gonna be a lot of this? No. Oh, my God. This is bad. What is this accomplishing?
Hey David, you mind if I like
eat almonds right next to you the whole time?
That is allowed within the rules.
Okay.
I do sort of mind though, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I don't want to be too rude.
Well, the initial search has revealed nothing.
You've been looking everywhere for this thing. You haven't given me a task yet. Are you okay?
You are gaslighting me.
I wouldn't say I'm gaslighting. Definitely gatekeeping and girl bossing, but not gaslighting. I found the balloon.
Found the...
Congratulations, you popped it.
Oh, wait.
Oh!
Well done, Ian. That was a good spot. So I wasn't crazy after all. I really did give you a balloon.
No. I wasn't related.
Okay. Thank you, Jackson.
Oh, thanks, Evan.
Good work.
Gaslighting.
Yeah, a bold strategy of gaslighting me into thinking that I would just, oh, I guess not. I guess let's move on to the next task.
Almost incredible to watch you slowly get more and more confused and discombobulated and then just eventually wander off.
Keep playing like loud noises and pretending you don't hear them.
Rearranging whole rooms behind him. Yeah. Like, what are you talking about? This is awesome. Like,
he's not allowed to physically attack me, but he realized he could mentally attack me. Yeah.
That's exactly what I was
saying. Okay, well, I'll give you the times. Ian was able to protect his balloon from me for 7 minutes and 13 seconds.
Okay. Good.
Jackson was able to protect his balloon from me for 7 minutes and 13 seconds. It was an exact tie. I double checked it, I triple checked it, they popped at the exact same moment. It was incredible. Yeah. Well, next, to try to spare their little balloon friends from me, David the Unstoppable Balloon Popper, are Brie and Cole.
Just to let you know, I'm locking the doors.
If I just tossed it over there, would it even be possible for him to find it? It depends if... Because if I could get it over there, he's not getting it out. The problem with the strategy is that it's so good that... I don't even know if David will ever be able to determine that he's lost.
The door is locked. I will use this door instead. This door is also locked.
What I should have done is more carefully barricaded that door, because he probably has a key to it. Okay, I figured that was too much to hope for.
Welcome to
Whoa. Thank you.
What the heck? Is this always under here?
What is this? This is an air purifier.
Yeah,
it's not under there. You just put an air purifier under there. I am not confident in this room, so I'm going to leave.
Still having a good time up there?
Yeah.
You want to come on down?
Oh, this is definitely new. Okay. But. Well, but the string just goes through the latch. Okay. This is not good. I've not found the balloon in the first scoop round. Any hints, Brie?
All the answers are on the task.
Oh. I believe I see it. I think it's over there, Cole. It'll be difficult to get, though.
Yeah. One might say that.
I'll just see it there, yeah.
Oh, shoot. It's an accountant.
That was a surprisingly effective performance from David.
Thank you. Why are the grocery bags in the dryer?
It's such a big balloon. How could I not find it?
It's not in.
Oh, actually, you were in here because.
The air purifier. Wait, it's gotta be in here.
Yes, 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 yes!
Great work, Brie.
Thank you, David.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Cathartic.
All due respect to Cole, but the sheer hubris on display. He's like, this strategy is so perfect. I'm just worried that David won't know that he's been truly defeated. After he just put the balloon in the rafters.
And then he's got a smug look when it's like out of reach. Like really smug.
Yeah.
And David's just like, whoop.
Yeah. I can imagine, because if you don't have darts, there's just no way to get that balloon. I was very happy that I had prepared darts in my jacket pocket in case somebody had done that.
Can I also say that David wouldn't have found it if I hadn't given him a hint to where it was in the end? Wow. I was actually like,
your hint was not helpful.
It was.
You said you've seen something related to it, and I'd seen a lot of things at that point.
Is there going to be a time penalty for the hint? Does Brie get an extra 5 minutes?
Okay, well, I'll give you the times, and you can decide, though, I guess. Cole protected his balloon for 8 minutes and 36, taking the lead off from Ian and Jackson. I think that locking me out of the cabin was the happiest I've ever seen Brie.
Yeah, I think we were all of us here were living vicariously.
For Brie, it took me 22 minutes and 8 seconds to find that fucking balloon.
David also had a lot of trouble telling that something was out of place. You know, he's like, was this here before?
Well, there was a lot of things that had just been moved and put in random places. I thought that was just like what was happening.
Exactly. Hard to tell when things are in a different
place. I knew which things had been moved.
Yeah. I mean, I love dwelling on Breeze. That was really good. But we do have to finish the episode.
Okay.
So do we want to see someone else's?
Yes. Okay. For the other attempts we've seen so far, we've gotten to see where they hid the balloon, and then we watched me hunt them down. Mm-hmm. For this next attempt, I think we're just going to see my perspective. So here's Eric's attempt.
Hello. Eric, I'm here to pop... Paul, yes. Is it, you've thrown a blanket over.
I have.
Some things here.
Or have I?
Well, I think you have. Oh, duct tape on this cabinet.
Indeed. It would be great if I could give you a hint, right?
Yeah, you can give me a hint if you want.
I said it could be great if I would, but I'm not going to.
Okay.
You see anything down there?
Nope.
You sure?
Yep.
Maybe you should get a flashlight back there.
Hey, David, I think you should look straight ahead of you. Like straight ahead. Look at how dumb you look right now.
I got,
did you?
Yeah.
Are you sure? David, are you sure you got it? Maybe you want to check the balloon.
What?
You might want to check the balloon, David.
Is this a fake balloon?
Is it? Is it?
How did, I left all the balloons in the green room.
Did you?
I literally did.
Are you sure? Maybe you should check the name on that balloon.
Steve.
How did you... Is there another balloon somewhere? Oh, that's so good.
That was legit. Oh! I see a balloon.
Is that Paul?
Well, I don't know. I can't see the name on it.
Could be just another imposter and you're wasting your time.
Is that it?
Okay. Good job.
It's a very good one.
Okay. Thank you, Eric.
Thank you, David.
Bye-bye. Wow.
Yeah. A strategy so good, David wouldn't even know if he lost.
Yeah, yeah, I kind of flubbed that. I should not have told him to look at the balloon. He could have just not found it.
I would have absolutely just gone home. Yeah. Never, yeah. Never. I would have discovered it when editing the task. It could have been. Yeah. But still, with his trickery, Eric was able to protect the balloon for 9 minutes 42. So. Finally, with a completely new approach to this task, we've saved Parker for the very end.
Everybody else is gonna be hiding it. So maybe I just wanna put it somewhere where David can't get it, but he can see it.
Hello?
Oh, Parker?
Yes.
Hello, can I come in?
Oh. No.
Is your balloon in here?
Do I have to tell you?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, it is.
Okay. Can I come in?
No.
I don't... There's a window like this in that room, but they do not open from the outside.
I think short of like... having like a football star break this thing down, I don't know how you would feasibly get into this room.
Can I give you $20 to open the, to let me in?
Give me a moment. I would say I could be convinced for maybe $30.
Okay, yeah, $30 deal.
I didn't think he could do it. I really didn't think he could do it. I never suspected bribery. David, you should be able to get in. All right, okay. Come on in. This is a.
Thank you.
This is my humble abode, as it were.
Okay, where's the balloon?
I've accomplished my end of the bargain. I let you into the room.
Oh God! Better be in here. Oh. All right.
All right, David. It was a pleasure accomplishing this task with you.
Great work, Parker. Well,
thank you.
You won in a different way. Well done.
Thank you.
Bye.
I mean, you've now, for the second time this season, someone has put a dollar value on points.
I was able to pop Parker's balloon in just 5 minutes 35, so Parker will be leaving this task with 1 point and $30.
Lucrative. Lucrative, to say the least.
Gotta respect the grind.
True.
Okay, so altogether, it is 1 point and $30 to Parker. A tie for fourth place, so 3 points each to Ian and Jackson. 4 points to Cole, 5 points to Eric, and the winner of that task is Brie.
All right, and with that, can we see the final scores of this show?
Yes, I will now announce the final scores of this episode.
You guys gotta stop doing that.
He's thirsty.
Are you thirsty, David?
No.
I don't know what, no one's
no,
told
you.
Me what this is.
All right, well, I can say, with that episode, Parker has in fact sold his episode victory for $30. The winner of this episode is Brie.
All right, Brie, play us out.
I forgot the tune.
Yeah, and with that, welcome to the end of Taskmaster Season 2, Episode 7.
Yeah.